There's quite a performance taking place in Minnesota's prairies right now, and it comes compliments of some wild chickens. Photojournalist Devin Krinke gives us an up-close look at a springtime prairie ritual.
There's no better way to spend a morning.
The stage is set.
There's one right over there.
And Liz Beery is ready for the band.
All right, maybe it's time to party.
A performance with the birds playing the bass. Prairie Chickens, Minnesota Spring DJ.
It's just amazing to be up and close and personal with wild birds. Getting a little feisty.
All this in an attempt to catch a girl's eye.
They're definitely charismatic. Wonder if they're just dissing each other. Your feathers look ridiculous.
They're comical, humorous, the old maroon call. They're just fantastic birds. There's no doubt about it.
Brian Winter is the president of the Minnesota Prairie Chicken Society, a nonprofit formed to raise awareness of prairie chickens and the grasslands they call home.
It's a tremendously rare place anymore. If you look at the original tall grass prairie, which was roughly two-thirds of the state, we're down to, you know, really like one-third of 1%.
The DNR says prairie chickens are a species of special concern, meaning they are uncommon in the state. See that bright yellow? That's the only place in Minnesota prairie chickens can be found today.
There's a lot of conservation work that has been done and needs to continue to be done on grasslands to keep them here. It would be just heartbreaking for me and many others if such a wonderful bird with such colorful displays that was here for hundreds, thousands of years prior to our settlement sort of disappeared from this landscape.
Makes me feel so connected to nature.
A performance worthy of an encore.
I could come out here every day and listen to this and I'd be a much happier person for it.
Near Glendon, Minnesota, Devin Krinke, Carol Evan News.